very much, Colleague Bobby Morris. Good evening to all of you. Those on St. Michael West, thank you for allowing us to come into your home and join with you this evening. Those, of course, from my constituency at St. James South, who journey here as well, and all of you from Barbados, and those who are joining us on the World Wide Web, since I believe this is being webcast abroad. This is indeed a very wonderful feeling. This is the Democratic Labour Party, whom a few months ago they felt that we were asleep as a political party. Now they cannot handle us in this country. The Barbados Labour Party, that is. You've heard some wonderful speakers go before, and I have only a few minutes to join with you this evening. But I want to know that you to know that this, even though we are on the end of independence, we are very much at the beginning of the Christmas season, where we ought to exhibit the greatest amount of love, care, compassion, including that for our enemies. But let going after the Barbados Labour Party know that when Christmas is over, all hell will break loose in this country. You see, Oinafa has some belief that he has the right to run this country. Oinafa and his band of cronies believe that they have a right to intimidate the life of the average Barbadian. We have shown you in the Democratic Labour Party time and time again that there is a better way. You just heard my dear friend Dr. Esteban Sukhu speak about leadership. And I just want to spend a few seconds on that particular issue. Reflect on the kind of leader Oinafa was. Very caustic, abusive, disrespectful. When Oinafa called you, you trembled. When your phone rang and it said, Oinafa, you pee yourself. Compare that now to Fronda Short, who when he calls, you smile right away. You are eager to take up the phone, and he doesn't start by letting go a few bad words. He says, good morning, ma'am, good morning, sir, how are you? That is the kind of leader you have. That's the kind of character you have as a leader. It is that very strong Christian-like leadership that has been able to keep this ship of Barbados steady and afloat for the last couple of years. First with David Thompson, a very dynamic leader who perhaps we can all say went too soon, and followed by Fronda Short, current Prime Minister, who is continuing to show strong leadership. And these gentlemen had been schooled by the likes of Errol Wharton Barrow. I certainly had, as Bobby mentioned just now, the honor of coming into the Democratic Labour Party back in 1981 at, I believe, the age of 15 or so. So I couldn't drive, I couldn't vote, but I knew how to take the BFA bus down the Bevel and walk across George Street to DLP. Where I sat and I listened, I didn't read the textbook, I sat and I listened to the likes of Errol Wharton Barrow, Erskine Sandiford, Evelyn Graves, Bradford Tate, Warwick Franklin, Maisie Barker Welch, a whole bunch of them. Men and women who had gone through the ringer, who knew what it's like to persevere, to stay focused, and to keep a society and economy together. These are our forefathers who built a strong Barbados, who have now passed the baton on to us, and we have not failed you, I believe. We have done very well under the circumstances, but that is because we had strong Christian upbringing, and we had the temerity to succeed and to stay focused. I've said before, I say it again this evening, Barbados is not an island existing in a world of its own. Since 2008, we have been faced and caught up in the world's worst economic recession. There's no doubt about it. Oinafa will want you to believe that this was the making of David Thompson or Fronda Short or any one of us in the Democratic Labour Party. This is a global recession, and all of you are tuning, and all of you know exactly what has been happening around the world. You also know what your Democratic Labour Party government have been doing for you. Because we believe that Barbados is not just an economy, it's also society, and we've therefore taken initiatives and programs to keep this society together. We've also been able to weather the economic storm by and large by ensuring that we put the right policies and programs together. Now, as Owen Arthur and his cronies continue to curse us and vilify us in this country, we are still able to ensure that our young children go to school in a very safe manner. Arthur don't believe in that. We still ensure that when our children get to school, the school plan functions. We are still able to employ, to retain excellent teachers in this country. And I say kudos to all of the teachers who are responsible for our children at least 6 to 7 hours per day. So we do function. When school is out, particularly in summer holidays, the parents can go to work and know that their children are being looked after in a very safe environment through our summer programs. It's costing taxpayers $6 million a year. $6 million per year to take care of 12,000 children. Owen Arthur didn't quarrel when he was spending $6 million on the St. Joseph Hospital inquiry that not one fellow got locked up for. But today he wants to quarrel because we are taking care of 12,000 young people during the summer holidays, ensuring that they do something constructive. Also that 700 Barbadians have a chance to hone their entrepreneurial skills and cater into the summer camps. Owen Arthur and Barbados Labour Party wants to put an end to that. So all of you who are parents, and all of you who are young entrepreneurs, I urge you to pay close attention to what is coming from the Barbados Labour Party. Your future is at stake here. We also have done wonderful other social programs that reflect on keeping society together. We just, for example, a few weeks ago in Parliament, made provision so that those young women in particular, and some men who go to the court and turn back empty-handed, are not able to go home with a few dollars that can keep them together. And let me make it clear, because the Barbados Labour Party is a wicked, malicious bunch of people. They go there and give the impression that we are saying the young men in Barbados in particular, don't support your children, the government will do it. That is not true. We don't want our young women to do as you saw the actress performing a few minutes ago. That is what the Barbados Labour Party would like our young women to be doing. We are saying to them, do not go home empty-handed. Take at least a little $50 that can help put some food on the table and feed your family until things get a little better. So we've acted responsibly in this country as a government. I want now to shift a bit to some other issues taking place in and around Barbados. And tell you about leadership and the kind of characters we have. I'm not going to talk about William Dugan. He has no damn manners. I did not, all I say in that particular manner is that I did not provoke William Dugan. I did not speak anything ill about his wife or children. But I will tell you this much. It is that little runty George Payne who looked across at me and said, I am going to tell Barbados that you talk about his wife and children. And then they went out there immediately on the social media, not to castigate Dugan for his bad behavior, but to say that I provoked Dugan, but he's not a child. I have known him for over 30 years. At school, we used to call him Humpty Dumpty. Today, those of us who are still close friends with him call him the Pillsbury Door Man. But the reality about it is that what annoys me is not just what Dugan said, but the conduct of the Barbados Labour Party since then to come and say that they stand solidly behind him. Is a kind of reflection of the kind of leadership that Barbados can expect from Owen Arthur if he ever made the mistake in returning this country under the Barbados Labour Party. So they would do anything to get their hands back on the purse string in Barbados. Let me tell you this. This Democrat Labour Party did not unfold its arm and say there's nothing we can do in this country. Look at every sector in this economy and you can see that despite the global recession, despite the downgrades and the state of our trading partners, we are still able to keep the agricultural sector together. Thanks to Dr. David Eswick, our initiative. We've been able to construct more houses in Barbados. We didn't have more money than Barbados Labour Party did. They have far more money than we did. But this bunch of individuals who are in Africa called riffraff, goons and hooligans have shown that we have more brain than they do and we are prepared to use it. So when we said to Barbadians, those who live in national housing units for 20 years or more, pay up your rent and stop thereafter and you will own your unit, that has now mean that over 2,000 families in Barbados will own their own homes or own their own homes. That is an enlightened policy. Oinafa was busy and will continue to be busy if ever he comes back here to be taking care of the few who can own the homes on the west coast of Barbados. He's not interested in people like Haynesville in my constituency or Silver Hill or Gore Hill. He will use them. His candidates will use them, but they're genuinely not interested in them. We have constructed more houses across Barbados. We didn't do like what Liz Thompson did with Lady Bird houses and Bluebird houses and whatnot around there. We genuinely been able to handle the keys. But it goes beyond that. It's not just the working class, and I want to make this point. Because the Barbados Labour Party and some would like people to believe that we are only interested in taking care of those at the lowest socioeconomic rung. We've also said the middle class Barbadians and those further up the scale that I'm duty-free or VAT exemption on building materials up to $400,000 on houses. That is very much targeted at the middle income Barbados. 72 houses are about to be constructed in West Terrace Gardens in my constituency. That is middle income housing as well being provided in this country. So we've done very well as a government with the limited resources that we've had in this country. And when we talk about healthcare, Michael Carter said I talk about these things too often, but the reality about it, Jerome Doolittle Walker had an opportunity for several years. Let me tell you about that character, Jerome Walker, that went after PG. He is Owen Arthur's best friend. Every morning they get up, Jerome will phone Owen and start to sing that song, Stuck on You. They're very, very close together out there. He had a wonderful opportunity. He served as a surgeon in the QEH for several years. He was plucked from there by Owen Arthur, made Minister of Health, and sat there for years and was responsible for the demise of our healthcare sector. He should have known better. Jerome Walker has not changed. Owen Arthur has not changed. These are the same individuals who are coming out to tell you that they can do better, they want to do better. Let me tell you something. Tell Jerome Walker to go visit the QEH and have it looking better than we've been able to do it in the last 4 years in this country. We are not yet there, but as you look towards the future, you can rest assured that the Democratic Labour Party will continue to place healthcare at the forefront of this society needs. We recognize that every individual, regardless of their calling in life, regardless of their religion, the color of their skin, whatever, they have a right to access decent healthcare. And that is what drives this Democratic Labour Party, and that is what we will continue to provide in this country for all and sundry. Owen Arthur had all the money in the world. He liked to boast of how good the economy was. Borrowed $300 million for a rainy day. Could not complete the St. John Polyclinic. That will be done this financial year as well. So I want you, ladies and gentlemen, as you look forward, as I said at the very beginning, this is the Christmas season, and we must all exhibit the greatest amount of love, as St. Paul said to the people of Corinth. I believe it's chapter 13, when he talked about love, faith, charity, etc. Let us reflect on these things over the Christmas season. But when that is over, we will have to fight the length and breadth of this country to secure a better future for our children. This is not about governance. This is not about founders, sure that any one of us, you sitting here. It's about the future. It's about our children. It's about ensuring that we do not go back to the brand of politics where people gather every day and live in a life of intimidation. Where there's a feeling that you can't get anything done unless you support the Barrister Party. You know, under this Democrat Labour Party administration, the bees have been able to keep so much noise around here. It could not happen if Arthur was in office. All of you would be intimidated. Many of you would be afraid to wear your yellow and blue. Let us not go back to those dark days. We are satisfied that we have been able to lay the solid foundation for a restructured economy. We are satisfied that we are able to identify niche opportunities of continuously in the international business sector to make the entrepreneurship opportunities available in education, for example, to reform healthcare. We are promising and are able to display to Barbadians that we as a team, led by Founder Stewart, have the intellectual capacity, we have the intestinal fortitude, and we have the character to lead and direct the affairs of this country. So ladies and gentlemen, have faith. The Democratic Labour Party is here to stay. We are here to continue to lead this country on the better days. Thank you very much.